Today, I'm going to show you how you can accelerate your net worth dramatically using what I like to call the bolt-on wealth strategy. Let's dive into it. Yo, Greg here, and I got another cool buying strategy for you if you want to grow your net worth as an entrepreneur. The bolt-on wealth strategy is actually pretty simple. So the basic concept of it is that instead of focusing on more traditional marketing channels such as Facebook ads or SEO, you instead look at acquiring businesses that are related to your main business as a marketing engine in of itself. Now, the process is simple, and this can be a fantastic way to grow your wealth, but that doesn't mean there aren't mistakes to avoid. And those mistakes I'm going to go into later in this video to help you out if you choose to do the bolt-on strategy. But before we do that, I need to talk about something called synergy first. So you see, synergy is a pretty simple term in itself. You have something, let's say it's jump ropes, and you have something like barbells. They are related, right? You could have two different companies and buy the barbell company to help grow your jump rope company, or vice versa. And the cool thing about this strategy is 1 + 1 doesn't usually equal 2. Usually 1 + 1 in this type of setup equals 4, 5, or even 10. And you can see this happening all the time in the industry, whether it's internet businesses or more traditional businesses. Mergers and acquisitions like this happen all the time. Just recently, HubSpot bought The Hustle, for example, a gigantic newsletter that people absolutely love. Now, why would they do that? Because they saw the benefit of using that as a new content marketing channel to promote HubSpot. And The Hustle is filled with entrepreneurs, so it was probably a good buy that probably started paying rewards for HubSpot fairly quickly to own that content channel. Now, The Hustle was already making money, right? It was an already profitable business in of itself. What HubSpot decided to do was buy the business, retool it slightly. It's still profitable and now is driving tons of leads and mindshare to the HubSpot platform. And that's the power of synergy. So you can use the bolt-on wealth strategy to grow the power of your dominance quite quickly inside of your industry while also buying something that is already self-sustainable. So in marketing, we call this a self-liquidating funnel. The funnel itself, the ad, usually the way it works is you run an ad, there is a little offer, maybe it's $7, $20 or whatever. People buy that and it makes your ad for free. And on the back end, you sell them what you're really trying to sell, whether it's a course, a service, a product, whatever, right? So this is the same thing, only at a larger scale with the bolt-on wealth strategy. In this case, The Hustle is that tripwire. It is the initial sale that is easier to get that makes the marketing for free because The Hustle already makes money. So HubSpot can tap into that audience anytime they want, effectively for practically nothing at the end of the day. Now, the bolt-on wealth strategy can be done at all kinds of spectrums. If you're thinking like, well, I'm not HubSpot. I do not have this gigantic audience, right? How can I possibly even compete on this? But don't worry, there are bigger people doing it than HubSpot, and there are much smaller people doing it than HubSpot. We have tons of entrepreneurs on our marketplace at Empire Flippers that are buying businesses specifically for this reason. And keep in mind, the business you buy doesn't necessarily just have to help your main business, like I already mentioned. It can also be the other way around, where you can get people onto the other business. So in the Hustle and HubSpot example, HubSpot made a big buzz about it that probably took the Hustle to whole new heights with new entrepreneurs that had never heard about it, but they were very sold on the HubSpot platform. Now they're checking out the Hustle, and guess what they're doing? They're probably sharing the Hustle because it's way easier to share cool articles from the Hustle than it is to constantly be talking about a CRM, right? So they get to grow their audience both ways. So you can use these businesses to really become like these teammates that make each other so much stronger. And it doesn't have to just stop at one business, by the way. In fact, once you get the bolt-on wealth strategy really working for you, you're probably going to be a bit addicted to the process because it can be so amazing what it can do for your business. And you see this with big conglomerates like what Facebook and Google have become. How many companies have Google and Facebook bought? Doing Instagram, they try to buy Snapchat, all sorts of big businesses. And these they just keep doing it. And why do they keep doing it? It's because they want to own the entire value chain. What I mean by the value chain is basically they own every step in that industry. So it would be like us owning a bunch of content sites about buying and selling online businesses, and then other content sites about entrepreneurship, and so on and so forth, until basically we own some kind of profitable property in every aspect of buying and selling online businesses, and ultimately online businesses themselves, whether it's services, SaaS products, whatever, right? We own the entire value chain. And that is something you see companies do all the time as well, such as Amazon. Sometimes they buy them, sometimes they create them. Amazon has their marketplace, obviously their big one, but they also have the AWS services that so many businesses use, including a lot of the FBA entrepreneurs. And FBA itself is another example of Amazon owning the value chain. Then there's also Amazon's financing component that they have for sellers. Again, another aspect of the value chain of their industry that they own. And you can do this with the bolt-on strategy over time, where you own a bit of every single piece of the puzzle of your market share, and you can really go to ham. Now, you can't go so ham where you become a monopoly, because that's bad. And monopolies are basically the ultimate professional epitome of owning an entire value chain, whether through just being really, really good at what they do, or usually through some more unscrupulous means. But we're not talking about that, so let's get that out of here. Okay, so here's how you do it. When you're doing the bolt-on wealth strategy, there's really two things to take into account: audience and profit. Now, the second part you might be tricked into thinking is the more important of the two, but it's actually not. It's the weaker of the two in the bolt-on wealth strategy. And the reason why is because profit, you only really need the asset you're going to acquire to be so profitable where it's self-sustaining. You're not really looking for hyper growth necessarily, like that's not a bad thing, but it's not a requirement for the strategy to really sing for you. Audience is the most important thing, because audience is what will carry you to allow you to do that 1 + 1 = 5 across your different business assets. The audience is always the most important. So when you go out to do bolt-on wealth strategies, ask yourself, is there a different audience here that I can tap into for my main business? Do they love the brand that I'm buying? Are they interacting? Are they engaging? All that kind of stuff. Because audience in the long term, if you plan on being in business for say 5, 10, or 20 years, is gonna be the most important asset you can build, much more profitable than actual just profit numbers, which sounds weird because it's more intangible, but there's just so much you can do with an audience, between data, between getting customer crossover, to getting them to share and grow something much bigger. Like for example, there's a list in Empire Flippers at our HubSpot where these people have never bought or sold a business with us, but we know, like, okay, if we want something to get a little bit more content engagement, we know this subset of our audience are super fans. Even though they've never been a customer of ours, they just love our content. And so we'll send out an email to them like, hey, check this out. We think you'll like it. What do? They go watch it, and hopefully they did like it. And then they share it with their friends and their peers. And guess who they are? Our target market typically, right? And those people might become customers even though the super fan never did. And that's the power of audience. You're able to build all these brand ambassadors and evangelicals of what you're doing. Hey everyone, hard transition, gray shirt Greg here to let you know I messed up on this video. And this is actually kind of a common problem with me. I am long-winded. And so what meant to be a 20-minute one video turned into a 40-minute extravaganza. And I am splitting the bolt-on wealth acquisition strategy video into a 3-part series. Good news is it's already done. So you won't have to wait very long. They'll be coming out every week. So make sure you like, subscribe, and leave a comment if you like this. And I am about to go do a bunch of more hard transition, gray shirt Greg cuts in the other videos. Cause it wasn't just the bolt-on wealth strategy. It was another video I did for you guys too about the daily life in a digital marketing manager's life. So hopefully the hard cuts don't hurt my retention. And if it does, you know you can make up for it by just watching the video 50 times on mute. You don't even need to listen to it. Just hit that like button with your 100 different YouTube accounts. I'm talking to you, my SEO friends. Talk to you later and see you in the next video.